Welcome everyone to AI Dev Days. We are so excited to have you here. I'm James Montemagno, and with me, the one and only Jay Parikh. How's it going, Jay?
Good, how are you, James?
I am absolutely excited about this moment. This year has been astonishing. And really, AI Dev Days is all about pulling together everything from the last few months for developers, for enterprises, for everybody, really. It's been so exciting, and not just the platforms, but the tools, and seeing them work together is just really revolutionizing how things are working today for users, but also developers.
Yeah, absolutely. I think the other thing that's super exciting is even the notion of who we consider a developer in our community is changing because the tools are advancing. There's so many different types. They show up in different work areas. And they're so much easier to use now, right? So anybody can approach these tools and start experimenting and kind of learning and adapting and keep trying these things out. And the technology is changing so fast. So every day it keeps changing, and what was not possible yesterday might be possible today.
Yeah, and like we've had so many amazing developer events, right? Ignite, GitHub Universe, .conf, and what we want to do is pull it all together.
That's right.
Say 2 days, really focus, bring the best of the best, and things have changed since then, which is kind of crazy to think about. You know, it's not just months or years, it's days. Every time I open up VS Code, Insider's Build, there's something new. I went on holiday for 2 days, I came back, whoa, it's all brand new. You know what I mean? It's amazing. I think what's really cool is we're not just having awesome live presentations, we're doing live workshops too. So it's gonna be really actionable and hands-on.
Absolutely. Yeah, I think the being able to bring these different events together, but everything that's happened leading up to GitHub Universe, between Universe Ignite and everything since Ignite, because we continue to learn from the community, we continue to learn from our end users, developers, getting feedback, keep jamming and developing and delivering on this roadmap, right? Because it is one changing, but also what people are trying to do with these tools, with the platform is also evolving. So we wanna be adaptive, we wanna be moving faster and faster and faster so that uptick in pace, that uptick in just production of new tools, new capabilities, enhancements, bug fixes, et cetera, is something that we're really, really fixated on right now.
Well, let's talk a little bit about what people are going to see over the next 2 days, right? I think when we think of Ignite and we think of all the amazing things in Foundry of how people are building and infusing their apps with AI, there's a lot there. Like, what's really exciting you about like what we announce at Ignite and what people are going to see here on day one?
On the platform in Ignite with Microsoft Foundry, and there was a lot of things announced at Ignite, right, across the entire Microsoft ecosystem. But within Foundry specifically, the big evolution for the team and I and for us is like moving out of just having models and all kind of the surrounding systems around the models, but bringing in knowledge, bringing in able to bring in your enterprise data or your organizational data, building in different frameworks, and you can bring your own framework, you can use our agent framework. So how do you build these complex kind of workflows and these agentic systems for your business, for your startup, for your enterprise? Because now you have model choice, you have lots and lots of models. We brought in Anthropic, so now you got another like awesome company lab building and contributing to the Foundry model catalog. We've got things like Model Router. If you're confused by all these models, you can just say, hey, I want to start off with the Model Router, let it kind of calibrate and help you. Then bringing in the orchestration and being able to actually do these more complicated 3, 4, 5 agentic systems that might be handling a higher ROI kind of purpose in your business, right? And then the important thing for any organization, but we obviously hear this being a showstopper for any mature organization, which is that observability, that security and trust baked in from the start, right? Because everybody is excited about agents, but if I can't observe it, if I can't police it, if I can't see what's going on, if I can't block it, and see if even it's like working correctly, then I'm going to be nervous. I'm not going to deploy these things. I'm going to keep prototyping things, but I'm not going to put them into production, right? So all of that coming together and completing more of that story and really having that full end-to-end platform story is what I'm like super excited to see what people are going to do with it now.
Yeah, I thought it was so amazing when you talk about model choice, right? I go in, I have my own application of deploying and using Microsoft Foundry every day. And when a new model comes out, I have a staging environment. I get to test like in real time, in seconds. Like it's right, so cool right. To be like, all right, wow, I'm now switching from 4 to 5 and 5 to 1.
And you can see the side by side.
It's like, it just really blows my mind. And I think today in day one, you're really gonna pull all that together, build agents, you're gonna see how MCP brings together, how Foundry brings it all together, and build your own too later today as well. Now, Jay, I don't know how many times you've been to GitHub Universe, but this is my first GitHub Universe, and it was absolutely amazing.
It was awesome. It was my first too.
Was it really? What did you think?
I thought it was just fantastic. We had, I think, like 4,000 folks there in Fort Mason. And just the energy, right, in terms of like what people are excited about with the technology. Obviously, super important for us to connect with the community, our open source contributors, like just really, really great to get everybody to kind of talk about where the ecosystem is, where we need to work on, how we're pulling all this stuff together. And everything's changing so fast, right? Because we announced a lot of things at GitHub Universe too. I'm curious what struck the most besides what you presented.
Well, you know, I think at GitHub Universe, it was so great to work so close with the GitHub team, the VS Code team, and the Copilot team pulling it all together. I mean, there was such a great buildup with like the Copilot CLI being launched, but to me, it's really pulling it all together. Just like you're saying in Foundry, VS Code and GitHub pulling Agent HQ together, I think really has honestly revolutionized how I work. Already at the beginning of the year with Agent Mode, I was like, wow, I'm shipping more code than ever. And it's like every week, every day, I feel like I'm more productive. I'm shipping more code, higher quality code. I'm reviewing code faster than ever and pulling it all together and being able to fire off background agents,
right?
Cloud agents. And I'm just reviewing. I was boarding this flight. This is a real story. On the way to Japan, we booked this trip like back in January. I was so excited, but I was at the airport. I was like, I have an idea for an app. I didn't bring any laptop, anything.
Yeah.
But I have the GitHub app. I opened it up, created a new repo, fired off an app, ask to it. I created a whole PRD, opened an issue, assigned it to Copilot, got off the plane in Tokyo. I had the app built. Like, it was like there, it was ready for me. And I was iterating on the trains. And like, that just blew my mind. I got home, opened up VS Code, everything was there, booting it up, seeing it run on my iOS simulator. It was like so cool. Like, and never imaginable in my mind, in my life, that we could be able to do that. So actually to see that stuff come together, revolutionary.
Yeah, and you're going to see more in like more and more stuff coming together in Agent HQ, right? Because it is really the focus there is really to make sure everything across that traditional software development lifecycle is AI powered, right? Yeah. From your just having that idea and being able to use something, maybe even like SpecKit or something else, and be able to kind of just go and create and think and type what you're imagining. If you want three versions of this thing, you can ask it to create three versions. Yeah. And then when you get off the train, you can be like, hey, A, B, C, I like B. Let's go flesh that out more. But then let the agents, this team of agents, right, go build the thing. You can have other agents that review, look for quality, look for compliance, maybe assess security vulnerabilities and bugs in it, write the tests. And then I'm excited about what people are going to do with custom agents I think this is super cool because like if I'm, you know, building my own startup and I've got to produce end user documentation, API documentation, I'm going to have my way of doing my documentation, my style, my brand, certain fonts, whatever. And I can embed that into this custom agent and this custom agent kind of rides along with me as I'm developing and building projects. And it's writing the documentation, right? This is like code documentation as I'm building the app. It's part of the product experience. It's not something that's lagging the product experience. So the end user of your service is going to be just absolutely a lot more delighted.
It's like before you take weeks to onboard somebody into your project. Now, all that knowledge just part of your programming experience every single day with that agent by your side, which is so cool.
Yeah, and we have a lot of work to do, right? I mean, it's still so early in terms of what this platform, what these tools can do, and just even having these ideas of being able to do and work a different way and thinking about how it's so easy now to have an idea, write something up, have it go async and work on it. You could be doing something else, right? And in a meeting, collaborating, meeting a customer, doing something while this thing is building, you come back and you can kick off another project, right? So I think that just, it's a new way of working that is gonna be fascinating to adapt to.
It really is. And it has for me at least, and everyone I talk to as well. And day two tomorrow is gonna be all about all the brand new advancements that we're talking about here and so much more. Like you said, there's so much in this. Now, you have, Jay, been talking to tons of developers, tons of startups, tons of innovative companies all over the globe. Like, what are you hearing? Right, we can talk about it.
Yeah.
We can tell our stories, but what are the stories that you're hearing from folks that you're talking to?
Yeah, in my short less than a year in the role in Core AI here at Microsoft, I've spent time with hundreds of startups around the globe, right? And this is something that we are investing a lot of time in, working obviously with the larger enterprises and that transformation and sort of new way of developing products and the actually really defining and learning and creating and thinking through what is the future of software, right? So the things that I often hear and end up talking to people about are really going to be kind of two things. And kind of one thing I encourage is whatever we are all doing today in terms of building, we have to all, and we should all just raise our level of ambition using these tools, right? Because we don't actually understand, there's a very small set of people probably in the world that truly understand what these models, what this technology, what you can do with even the protocols like MCP and agents and the models, different models, closed models, open models, and then what you can do to those models with fine tuning and RL and whatnot. So there's just so much to really build in terms of value out there. And I just always think that whatever level of ambition you have for a project, a feature, a bug, your business, a startup idea, you should just raise it, because like chances are it's closer, you know, to it's just a greater probability that the technology is going to actually just amaze you in terms of what it can do. Yes, there are some, you know, jagged parts of it and it doesn't always work perfectly, but just raise your level of ambition of what you're trying to do, what your business opportunity, your startup idea is, your application idea is, just raise it, because I think most of us are getting surprised in terms of what we're actually able to achieve, right? And the second thing that we always want with our with our developers internally and with all the partners that we work with is we want feedback. Like, we want this tight feedback so that we can continue to just ratchet up how fast we're iterating and building and improving our products and our features and our tools and the platform, right? Because there's a whole system that has to change and adapt. And we want tight, like actionable feedback. And we want to, just as you spend a ton of your time listening to feedback and then improving the products with the end users, developers that you're tight with, we want to do that just around the world.
Yeah. And we're doing that internally too. I think that's the thing. You said you've just only been here a year, which is crazy to think about. But the year's been amazing. I mean, just the products that we have, the innovation, and we're living and breathing that. I think that's what's cool. And that energy comes in. And hopefully everyone at home or watching right now feels that, right? As we're shipping, we are coming out, listening to that feedback, taking actual steps. We're on the bleeding edge, the cutting edge, and delivering it all to all of you. So hopefully you're able to take this back and incorporate it every single day. And I really loved it. The energy that comes in, it feels like to me, like a new Microsoft in many ways. And it has been, it keeps innovating. And I think the push and the drive allows us to do just really unique, awesome things and partner up with such amazing companies around the globe and innovate together.
Absolutely. And I think there's just a lot to get out of AI dev days, right? Because trying to put all of this stuff together from these different conferences, all the different blog posts of things that we've shipped, and being able to get hands-on and really push your level of ambition, get in there, use these things, build stuff, break things, you know, really learn and give us that feedback, learn from each other, share. This is what this is all about. It's all about learning together in this community, and we just all have to learn faster.
Yeah. I agree 100%. And we're going to have a whole bunch of stuff throughout day one and day two. We're going to have a Discord. You'll find links everywhere below. We're going to be monitoring all the chats, taking your questions live right here. I think you said we want your feedback right here, live, when it's happening.
That's awesome.
Ask the people that are presenting. And I'm so excited about it.
And you might even file a bug and have Copilot go fix it while you're talking.
I get the feedback. I'm like, you want to raise the bug, or I'll raise the bug. I'll put it in and assign it away. And honestly, I did this recently with the Aspire team. I found this bug, they have this awesome MCP server. Yeah. And I was like, I like it, but I really want it easier to install. And I was like, here's what it should be. So I worked with Copilot, had it file the issue for me. I was like, assign it. I had James Newton King review it. He reviewed it, looked at it. It was literally merged within an hour of me.
Awesome.
It was like, that's the pace that we're on, just working together side by side, our developers, and this amazing new technology that we have. So AI Dev Days is happening right now. We're gonna kick it over to Katie and Christina to take away day one. So stick with us, ask your questions live. Hope you have a great AI Dev Days.